मेरे में थोड़ा टैलेंट है बैटिंग का, और नेट्स में बोलिंग ही नहीं, लेकिन जब भी हमारे थ्रो डाउन स्पेशलिस्ट जो है टीम के साथ वो अवेलेबल रहते हैं, बॉलर्स अवेलेबल रहते हैं, तो बैटिंग का भी प्रैक्टिस करता हूँ। और यही मोमेंट्स रहता है जिसके लिए हम हमेशा रुकते हैं कि कब अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलता है और टीम के लिए हम कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट कर सके। तो जब भी ये मैच में भी मौका आया तो दिमाग में और दिल में यही ख्याल था कि जाके वहां पे बैटिंग करना है। जितना देर अंदर मैं रुकूंगा पिच पे उतना फायदा होगा टीम के लिए, उतने रन्स ऐड होंगे और उतना लीड कम होते जाएगा। तो आइडिया था कि वहां पे अंदर टाइम स्पेंड करना पिच पे।
भारत सुंदर सर,
Thanks, Maulin. Shardul, just have you batted much with Washington Sundar before? And can you just talk about the partnership and 186 for six and to take it to 317? What is happening between you two on there?
honestly, I haven't batted with him much. It was only once or twice when I batted with him. I think once it was in T20 game, and once I batted with him in a practice game. But both of us have that temperament to, succeed at this level. And honestly, we weren't looking at the scoreboard. Like I said before, that the idea was to spend some time in there, and we knew that their bowlers were tiring out a bit. So it was matter of 1 hour. If we hung in there for 1 more hour, then probably, we would be on the top as a batsman because bowlers are already tiring out. So it was really important for us to hang in there, score off the all the loose deliveries, and both of us, we were communicating really well with each other. If someone trying losing his con focus or trying a rash shot, we would immediately communicate with each other that, let's get back to normal and just do our basics in there.
Thanks.
Yes. The next question is on chat from Prajakta. She says both you and Washi played controlled yet aggressive shots in the middle. What was the plan going ahead when both of you were new to the crease?
When we were new, we were trying to defend a lot, and as our partnership went on, we know that there's some true bounce here in GABA, and if bowler errs on his line and length, then we can put those away, put those loose deliveries away. So we were just waiting for our chance, honestly. Whenever there was a loose delivery bowled, we tried to put away for the four, or just take twos and threes hitting in the outfield.
Gaurav Joshi.
Hi Shardul, just it's been a long tour. How have you stayed so positive to ensure that last game and you'll get that match? How have you stayed positive?
Yeah, it's a long tour, and as a player, it's always challenging to stay motivated and do well in the last game as well. And series being tied at 1-all, this game turns out to be the most important one in the series. So you don't need an extra motivation to play this game. Just look at the score lines in the series and go out there, give 100% to the team, and just pray that you're making all the useful contributions and making the team win.
Yes, Sayak, if you are there, you can go now. Sayak, are you there?
Hi, Shardul.
Hi.
So, Shardul, my question is, what were the conversations between you and Washington during your partnership?
I think I have answered that before.
Yes.
Like when we were playing out there in the middle, if someone's trying to play some rash shot, then we would just communicate immediately that, okay, you're losing the focus, let's get back to normal and do your basics. And whenever there was break, like when session was ending tea time, or when drinks was about to happen, we would just communicate that, okay, let's slow down the game, the break is about to happen. So those were small little conversations we had in there.
Nimesh Patgaonkar followed by Kiran Ambani.
Shardul, great innings. Congratulations. This question is that we thought before the second new ball, Australia were trying to preserve their fast bowlers, but with the new ball also they tried with Lyon again, you know. So what was that? I mean, is it more of a cracks behaving? I mean, they're trying to capitalize on that, or how, the, or rather the pitch cracks are behaving? If you think about the fourth day.
I honestly didn't expect Lyon to come on immediately with the new ball because their fast bowlers were bowling well. But as you see, this is the fourth game in the series. Their bowling unit has bowled a lot, and probably now they're operating in shorter spells. So they brought Lyon very quickly with the new ball, and maybe they were expecting some bounce bounce and turn with the new ball as well, since it's always hard. And what was the next question you asked?
No. What do you think the cracks will be on the fourth day?
Let's see how it goes. I haven't played here much. It's all the stories I've been listening. So I have spoken to the groundsman, and according to the feedback, I think cracks will open up a bit. But honestly, I don't know how much it'll, you know, affect the game or affect their batting or our bowling.
Yes, Kuram Abhin.
Yeah, Shardul, how much do you think the 8 tours have helped you? Quite a few of you have toured before to other countries like Australia on with the A team. How much have they helped?
A tours are meant to be, you know, to give experience to your second lineup, and it has helped a lot. I mean, we were here in 2016. We played a couple of 4-day games in Allen Border Field, though the pitch there is a bit different, but at least you are used to the climate, you are used to the Australian conditions. So when you take that leap from India A to the Indian team, the transition is not that difficult. It's all about how you execute your plans when you play for the senior team.
Shriram Veera followed by Prasant Menon.
Hi, Shardul. Any interesting comment, remarks from the Australians when you're batting? And what, anything funny or the happiest moment that you will take away from this batting partnership?
They were trying to have a conversation with me, but I wasn't answering them. Once or twice, I just answered them in one word, but they were sort of normal questions. Even if they tried to sledge me, I did not hear it. I just ignored it and kept on playing.
Yes, Prasad.
Hi, Shardul. Was there any particular strategy to deal with Nathan Lyon and Mitchell Starc? Because the way Indians have dealt with them, it's been pretty impressive. And also, was there a difference in approach when you face the new ball? Thank you.
Every batsman have their own plans when they face a particular bowler. When I played Nathan Lyon, I saw he had kept all the fielders back for me. There was long on deep, mid-wicket, deep square leg. So it would have been foolish to try and play a big shot of him. So I was just trying to defend there. If he gives me a loose ball, I would take. The plan was to take just one odd single here and there. But he was bowling well. So equally, I had to, you know, keep my head down and bat as long as possible. And Mitchell Starc, I think after their second new ball, he was bowling really well. It was one of the fastest spell I played. He was really steaming in, but you know, we were batting well in the middle, and Washington and myself just kept telling each other that, okay, he's bowling well now, let's respect him. He's coming fast at us. So we would try and negotiate at that point of time, and then let's see if he bowls a loose ball, we would try and put it away.
We shall have last few questions now. Sandeep Bhai Dwivedi.
Shardul, you said about the India A tour and how it prepares you skill wise. But the way you entered, you might have not played or batted in this kind of intimidating venue, where which is said to be the den of Australia. People around your bat speaking out, but you walked in as if you are
walking at Wankhede, like you felt like so comfortable from the first ball. So what is it about you and even Washington that you were absolutely unfazed by the situation or the atmosphere? Like, what was the reason?
Yeah, when I walked in, the situation was difficult. I wouldn't deny that. The crowd was cheering for Australian bowlers. They were on top at that point of time. But I remember our coach, Mr. Ravi Shastri, saying right at the start of the one-day series that he said, if you perform in this country, you will be rewarded and people will love you for your performances. And that one thing was also on my mind that, okay, if I perform here, then people are going to love me. And eventually, end of the day, it's going to help my team. That was the biggest positive. And keeping those two things in my mind, I just kept playing. Like, no matter what, let crowd, you know, cheer for them. They would make noise, but, you know, just ignore and keep batting. If I bat well, if I hit few good shots, then the same crowd will also cheer for me. So I was just hoping for the turnaround, and it happened.
Thank you, Shardul. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you,
Shardul.